And you can't be focused on God's kingdom and righteousness and weary at the same time. Amen? Look at your neighbor and say, take a chill pill. Golly, get up in the morning, get on the prayer line and take a chill pill. So, you know how Jesus is a masterful teacher. He holds up the birds and say, look, have you seen these birds lately? They not working, but they eating. And guess who's taking care of them? God. And aren't you more valuable than they? Then he says, look at the lilies of the field. They have such glory, such beauty, such radiance, Solomon couldn't compare. And then he then gets us to focus upon our clothes. And if God will clothe the grass, which is not going to be around long, won't he clothe you? Amen? Won't he clothe you? Won't he take care of you? That's 2018. Won't he take care of you? Come on, look at your neighbor and say, won't he do it? Come on, say, won't he do it? Somebody's got a testimony that he will do it. Yes, Lord, he'll keep food on the table, clothes on your back, a roof over your head. Won't he do it? You got to start 2018 like that. Oh, yes, he's going to do it. I'm not going to be worrying and fearing about all this stuff. Then Jesus says this, and I'll be preaching on this later on. I can't do it today, but the Heavenly Father knows your needs. Come on, I just can't help it. Come on, somebody shout, he knows. He knows. Look here. He is omniscient. And he knows before you know. I don't know if my grammaticians are going to say, I should have said, he knew before you knew. But y'all get the point. Amen? So, gosh, that's why, since he knows before we know, that's why in 2018 we should seek first. If we refocus, we get all this other stuff the way we've been doing it, and now we're going to do it right, we're going to be in good shape. And let me give you three things. Refocus so you can focus. First, on the kingdom and his righteousness. To refocus, first, you've got to consider the clarity of your present focus. How clear are you really seeing? In other words, just to be honest, is what you're doing working for you? Is it working your way? The way of debt? The way of stress? The way of strain? Is that working? Number two, like I did this week, go get a checkup. You got to check what you're doing. Is it compatible with God's word? Is it compatible? Because you want everything to line up. You want it to line up. Is it compatible with God's word? Is the way I'm treating my wife or my husband, is that compatible? Is the way I'm approaching my work or my business, is it compatible? Is the way I'm handling my money, is that compatible? When the jackpot is up, when the jackpot is up over $3 million, will I spend $200 on lottery tickets and put $20 in church? said, check it out. Check out. Y'all start laughing. It was a big jackpot, wasn't it? And obviously, by your lack of praise this morning, you didn't win, did you? And the last thing, refocus. Change your focus to a kingdom focus. Change your focus to a kingdom focus. Change it to a kingdom focus. And then you're gonna see all the benefits and blessings of that. Now what I wanna do, I'm gonna come back to the text in a little bit in the message. I wanna give you quickly what we are refocusing and focusing upon this year at First Metropolitan. And at First Metropolitan, we have five priority focuses. Everybody say five. Five priority focuses here. First one is evangelism and the growth track, which is gonna be led by Elder Robinson, Lewis Robinson. Everybody give it up for Elder Lewis Robinson. Look here, this year you got to refocus. Seek first the kingdom. And what you need to be doing is like what Lady O was sharing with you, is understand we're about making disciples. So we need every member to reach others for Christ. You are God's missionary. You are God's evangelism on your job and in your neighborhood. You are God's missionary and evangelism in Kroger, in HEB, in the malls, wherever you go. You've got to reach others for Christ. And what we're gonna seek to do is train you in establishing relationships with others and praying for others. It's easy to pray for others, to ask someone on your job, can you pray for them? To ask the waitress, the waiter, is there anything I can pray for you? Pray for others. Share your testimony. Not all of it. Look at your neighbor and say, not all of it. But just what God has done for you. And invite people into the context of our church, our worship, our community life groups, our Wednesday nights, our special events. We want to do that. Look, we want to register at least 45, and that's a low number, 45 guests every Sunday. Amen? And that can only be done with you. It can only be done with you. And out of that, we believe that 15 people will join us and we'll get five baptisms each month. Can you say amen to that? Amen. And then we have, it's starting today, the growth track. Everybody say the growth track. In fact, Mike, go out there and bring me that black thing. Just slide that big, tall black thing that has the growth track in there. Bring that in here so I can get it. We start the growth track, which follows the pillars of our vision for making disciples. Now, this is what we're going to do with all our new members, but I want to invite you, if some of you would like to go to the growth track, you can. We'll fill that room up, and if we have to start another one, we'll do that. Every Sunday at 9:30, it's gonna make better disciples. It's gonna be so sound, and we're excited by what God is gonna do through the growth track. Can you say amen for the growth track? Amen. Now Mike is bringing us in, and so you're gonna see this here, Reverend Dr. Lane. Amen. It's right here, Mike. Just thank you. So you're gonna see that. It follows our pillars. Belonging, connecting, growing, and serving. And the reason I invite you to go, if you didn't go when I was teaching on Wednesday nights, is because the people who join our church will have the probability of being much sharper than you, who are already here. So because this is sound stuff. So I invite you, if you want to, at 9:30, stay, go to the growth track. Amen. Number two is community groups. Community connecting. We're striving to become a church of small groups, not just to have some or with small groups, but we want you in relationships. You're going to hear that over and over and over from me. We believe that discipleship best takes place when you're in relationships with other believers who are going through some of the same and similar struggles that you're going through. Can you say amen to that? Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, we all got issues. In fact, I heard a song on the radio the other day about some issues. Yeah, but you don't want to sing it here? Okay. All right. So we want you in godly, healthy relationships. And we're even going to transform our present classes and ministries into groups. And we want to add three each semester that we have groups. We're going to keep adding. And we thank God for our group effort. Lady O and Dr. J. Simpson Butler are working with our community groups. Let's give it up for them. Amen. Then we have our youth ministries, and that is a key area of our church at First Met, and we're remodeling over there, going to have the entrance way for our 12 and under. Our 122 tween ministry has already been remodeling, off and running, and they're doing awesome things with worship, small groups, trips, all that kind of stuff, and we want to double everything that we're doing this year in that effort. Elder Johnny Ogletree is leading that effort. Four is stewardship. Let's give it up for Elder Johnny. And four is stewardship, faith, forward, and our construction. Look, this year, you all, we want to break ground. Yay! Look here, and we can only do it if you are a tither. Amen. Tithes and offerings. That's just the basic way. And if you'll also pledge and give toward our Faith Forward campaign. Amen. 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 We've already begun talks with bankers and contractors. So the new sanctuary is coming. Elder Daniel Johnson is leading that effort. Amen. Then our last priority focus is our customer and member services. And we're looking at new ways to treat our members, our guests, and the people that work at First Met. In fact, all the people who work in ministry at First Met, we call them Dream Team. Amen? And so what we're going to do now, we have a special room that we have made for our Dream Team. Those who work on Sundays can go to this room and be refreshed. Everybody say amen. They can rest. They can be able to check their purses in, all that kind of stuff, whatever they want to unload. But we have a special room for them. We're going to now do our guest reception. Did anyone come in? Do we have any guests this morning? Any guests? Everybody's a member? Okay. Everybody's a member. There's one. Oh, gosh. I want to see you after service. Amen. Amen. We're going to. Thank you. But we're now going to treat our guests different. We're going to have reception for them. We're redoing our bookstore. We're redoing our new members room. Look, it's going to be great. We're going to take better care of our guests, our new members, and better care of you. But all these things we have to refocus and do. Amen. And that's what Jesus